It's almost 2020, which means we are nearing the end of the UN's Decade of Biodiversity. I've decided to make an entirely separate video about that designation, but I figured we needed to start by understanding biodiversity. So, what is it exactly? So first, what is biodiversity? Well, rather obviously, it's a portmanteau of the words biological and diversity, so that pretty much sums it up right there. But more explicitly, biodiversity is a term we use to talk about the variety of living things. This can include all forms and levels of life, from genes on strands of DNA all the way up to populations of species. The word can also be used generally to talk about all life on Earth, or it can have a more ecosystem or place-specific meaning. Ecologists use modifying terms to talk about biodiversity at different spatial scales. Alpha diversity is the biodiversity of a single community of organisms, so we can use this term interchangeably with the idea of species richness. Basically, species richness, or alpha diversity, is a measure of how many species are in a given community. In this example, the community has two species, blue and brown, so we could say it has low alpha diversity. Conversely, this community has four species, so it has a high alpha diversity. Beta diversity is the difference in biodiversity between communities. Say two communities are on either side of a mountain range, indicated by this knife. The communities probably have a few species in common, like red and orange, but the community on the left has the blue species, while the community on the right has the green and yellow species. This means that there are three species that are unique to one community or the other. But if the communities only had orange in common, and the community on the left had red, blue, and brown, while the community on the right had yellow and green, then there would be five unique species between the two communities, resulting in a higher beta diversity. And when we combine alpha, or local diversity, with beta, or between community diversity, we get gamma diversity, which can also be thought of as regional diversity. Let's say we have a large valley, which we'll designate as our region. Within the valley, we have a forest community on the left with red, blue, and yellow species. On the right, we have another forest community with red, green, and brown species. In the middle, separating the two forest communities, we have a grassland community with orange, pink, and purple species. So each of our three communities has three species, meaning they all have the same alpha diversity. But the beta diversity between the two forests is four, while the beta diversity between either forest and the grassland is six, and the gamma diversity for the entire valley or region is eight. Okay, so we've got some definitions, but why should we care about biodiversity? That's a great question, and a lot of people have asked it. Those of us working in conservation often find ourselves going, well, duh, but it's important that we have concrete answers. So biodiversity is important because individual species do different jobs in an ecosystem. You may have heard those jobs referred to before as niches, and no, I don't want to talk about the pronunciation of that word. The more species there are in an ecosystem, the more niches can be filled, so the more processes can happen in that ecosystem. For example, if we have an ecosystem with one tree species, then there will be roots to hold the soil in place, but the branches and seeds of that tree will just sort of be there. But if we add squirrels, suddenly the ecosystem has both erosion control and seed dispersal. If we add a hawk, then there will also be predation. So with increased biodiversity, we get an increase in the number and variety of processes happening in an ecosystem. But adding a new species doesn't always mean a new niche is filled, and that's okay too. Consider the forest we were just building. In addition to squirrels, there might also be mice. The squirrels and mice might compete with one another for food resources in the form of seeds from the tree, but they're also providing some redundancy in the system. Why is redundancy important? Well, say a disease runs through the squirrel population and kills almost all of the squirrels. Because the mice are still around, they continue to fill the niche of seed dispersal for the trees and the role of prey for the hawks. Biodiversity fills niches and provides redundancy fail-safes in the system. Of course, we can't talk about biodiversity without discussing some of the ways human activities compromise it. There are some obvious ones, like directly killing animals, but there are also more subtle ways we influence the biodiversity biodiversity around us. For instance, have you ever considered roads? Big multi-lane highways can act as barriers for wildlife trying to cross from one side to the other, meaning the genetic and species diversity of the communities on either side of the road might be negatively affected. A road or other human structure that prevents wildlife movement can be said to be causing habitat fragmentation because it separates the original large habitat into many smaller fragments. There's also outright habitat loss, of course. If a forest is clear-cut and no trees are left standing, then all of the animals and other plants that relied on the trees will now be homeless. Without suitable habitat, species like squirrels and tree-dwelling birds might disappear from the area, dramatically reducing the biodiversity. So, how important do you think it is to protect biodiversity, and which scale of diversity do you think is most important? What's the most biodiverse ecosystem you've ever visited? I'd love to hear your thoughts down in the comments. If you liked this video, don't forget to like it! If you didn't like this video, please share it with someone who would. And if you'd like to support The Roving Naturalist, remember to hit the subscribe button and the bell notification icon. Then go check out my Patreon page. You can also follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. If you'd like to learn more about biodiversity, then you should head on over to the Nature Check Twitch channel, where soon a bunch of other scientists and myself will be streaming video gameplay and talking about the biodiversity of the game Worlds. And as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.